Halloween time, right?
Halloween.
We have a special guest with us today. Sophia is home from school because she got
mono,
and she's been extremely sick, haven't you, baby?
And yeah. I'm just five.
She's five. That's 10. Show them five. Yeah, she's five. So today in our video, with Sophia's help, we're going to go over making the Tomatoa costume shell, and we're going to go over converting some found eyeball headband into Tomatoa eyes, right?
And his pupils are like right side big and left side small.
We did a little bit of character research and found out that his pupils don't match.
Yeah, because he's
He has had a concussion.
He ate his grandmother. So, but it took a week because he was absolutely humongous.
That's
right. Why are you here?
Yep, Sophie's ready. She's gotten into character. So, so hopefully we can get this done in 15 minutes and show you. I honestly don't even know what I'm going to do. I'm just going to kind of wing it, and I hope it works out, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Was to build more ridges so that when I do the paper mache I don't get like a saggy area, but she's five, so this needs to be really, really light. So I'm just gonna stick with the three ridges and use tape to bridge the gap between the ridges before I put the paper mache down. Okay, so what I've done is I use that EcoBond to plaster the backpack down to the shell. And then some of these were kind of rolling up a little bit. So what I did was Gorilla Wood Glue to secure these tacks down in there. And then I kind of painted over some of the tabs there with the Gorilla Wood Glue just to kind of smooth them out. And now I'm going to paint this to match.
Monkey.
So here we go. I'm not done, but I'm done enough that I can put this video up because I know it's October 8th and this took a little bit of time to build and we're coming up on a deadline. So I can show you what I've done here. On the outside, you can see we spray painted everything gold, used the wood glue to put the shells on. Now I'm going to go through my jewelry box and find the odds and ends. You can see I found a little anchor earring and a couple of little rhinestone earrings that I never ever wear. So I'm just going to kind of add on to this as I find things. And then I spray painted the backpack purple. So you can barely even see the edges there where I used the EcoBond to seal it down. So it holds really well. That was really my biggest fear with this whole thing. Wasn't so much making a shell that looked like Tomatoa, but getting it to hold comfortably on her. I didn't want to use elastic straps because that would make the shell bounce under the weight. So the backpack worked out really well and I'm really excited about that. So you saw, or you may have seen the other video where I got the red crab claws and painted those to match. I embellished some already made fuzzy feather. They were big green bloodshot eyes, and we made them look a bit more like Tomatoa with the paper clay and some acrylic paint. I'll put links to everything in the description as well. I got her some purple shiny pants, just a plain purple shirt that I may go through and accent with some blue fabric spray paint, which you can find at Michael's. The difference between the fabric spray paint and regular spray paint really is that the fabric spray paint is flexible. You can see here I used the regular purple spray paint on the backpack. It's incredibly stiff, so that's the difference there. It just covers a little bit better. I also got this Snazaroo metallic purple face paint and then cosmetic grade gold glitter. So what I was going to do is outline the edges of her face with the purple and then add some of the gold glitter around the edges too and leave the bulk of her face flesh tone. You can see he's mostly kind of like a pinkish color in the center there. Make sure if you ever put glitter on your face or on anybody's face, it's not craft glitter. It's the cosmetic glitter. Craft glitter has sharp edges. The cosmetic glitter won't cut your retina. That's no good. So, yes, if you've made a Tomatoa crab shell or a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle shell, I would love to see your pictures or link your video so I can take a look. If you have any ideas how I could have done this better, please let me know. I'd love to know. Now that I've done this once, I'm pretty sure I can fly through it a little bit easier than this first one. I really didn't know what I was doing. I had a vague idea or general idea of where I wanted to go, but I was really winging it a lot of it as well. So yeah, but I'm really, really excited about the final product. I'm not gonna have her get fully dressed for the video. I learned my lesson from previous years, getting her all decked out in her costume before the actual day, because once Halloween gets here, it's not as exciting. So I want her to have that excitement on the actual day. So I'm not gonna put her in full makeup and everything until October 31st. So yeah. Anyway, I hope that this was helpful to you. Thank you so much for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks. Happy Halloween.